Do you ever dream of not having to wake up early on a Monday morning and drag your body to work? Or do you feel stuck working your 9-to-5 job when you could be spending your time on something more meaningful to you, something that you're more passionate about? If you answer yes to any of these questions, then you're in the right place, because in this video, I want to share 7 simple steps you need to take in order to retire early in Canada. Hey, welcome back, this is Thomas, here to help Canadians to make better choices on retirement, wealth, and insurance. My goal is to make sure you can take 1 or 2 ideas home and start making financial decisions today. If this is something that you're interested in, consider subscribing. So, when it comes to the topic of retiring early, a lot of people tend to ask this question, what on earth am I going to do if I retire early? First of all, retiring early does not mean that you're just going to sit at home all day and not do anything. This is a very common misconception. If you ask a lot of early retirees, retiring early simply means that they don't have to get stuck at a 9-to-5 job that they don't love, and instead, they will be spending their time on things that they interest them, things that matters to them. Using a real-life example, one of my friends, Joey, used to be an accountant that makes 6-figure income. When he quit his job at the age of 39, a lot of people said to him, "You must be out of your mind to quit such a high-paying and stable job." To Joey, though, he still thinks that this has been one of the best decisions he made in his life. He used to always work well into the late evening during the tax season, and sometimes even on the weekends. He never was able to attend his son's soccer practice or his daughter's ballet class. But now that he's saved enough to be retired, not only can he spend more time with his kids, he even has time to pursue his true passion in the culinary art. You might be wondering, how was Joey able to do this before age of 40, while you're still stuck at your 9-to-5 job? It's actually not as complicated as you think, if you follow the right steps that I'm going to talk about shortly. Before I go over the 7 steps you need to take to achieve financial independence, I want to share where I get the ideas from. I was inspired by a guy named Dave Ramsey. Dave is an American radio show host and a businessman. In the last 25 years, he transformed from someone that declared bankruptcy into a multi-billion dollars with a net worth of estimate of $200 million. In Dave Ramsey's book, The Total Money Makeover, he went over how he used the 7 baby steps to turn himself from broke to debt-free, to financial independent, to even becoming financial abundance. So based on those ideas, and I add my own thoughts to it. So here we go, step 1, save for your emergency fund. This first step shouldn't be too hard to reach for most people, but don't underestimate the importance of this first step, because it will give you the most basic protection in case anything unexpected happens. I usually recommend it you should have at least 3 to 6 months of your expense saved aside as your emergency fund. And if you're really tight on your budget, at least get a pre-approved line of credit, but you do not, I repeat, do not borrow from your credit card as your source of emergency fund. If you already have this emergency fund saved up, then you can jump right to step 2, which is to clear all your bad debts. A lot of young adults start off their career with a bunch of loans like credit card bills, car loans, max out their line of credit. What Dave recommends is to use a strategy called a debt snowball method to clear your debts. In this debt snowball method, your goal is to pay off your smallest debts first, while you're paying only the minimum balance on the larger debts. This way, you can clear your debts one by one, starting from the smallest ones to the biggest ones. Once you clear all your debts, you should have some extra money for this next step, which is to get a life insurance and a sickness insurance. This will protect you against life's biggest surprise, such as accidents and sickness, without slipping back into the debt. For a term life insurance, it probably costs less than $30 a month for a young adult. Now that all your debts are clear and you have a safety net set up, congrats, you are almost halfway there. In step 4, invest 15% of your household income in retirement. It's never too early to start your retirement planning, no matter your age. If you want to retire early, you need to start planning for this even sooner. There are multiple investment vehicles for retirement in Canada, with the most common ones being RSP and tax-free saving. I'm not going to go into the details of how to use each of the retirement investment vehicles here. But if you're interested in learning more about them, feel free to go to my previous videos. Depending on how risk tolerant you are, you can either invest into the GICs, bonds, mutual funds, ETFs, stocks, or combination of these. No matter what you decide to invest in, the main point here is take 15% of your household income and start investing it into your retirement. My advice is you can invest this money long term. Try to invest places that give you at least 6% and above in average. If you're not a very disciplined person or you don't think you can put 15% right off the bat, I highly recommend you to open a dedicated bank account for this and set up an auto deposit such that every time you get paid, whether it's weekly, bi-weekly, monthly, a portion of your paycheck will automatically deposit into the account. By doing this, you don't even have to worry about if you have anything left at the end of the month to contribute towards your emergency fund account. Remember, it's not how much you save, it's how early and how frequent you saved. If you don't have any investment experience or you're not exactly sure what you're doing, I will more than happy to help. The next step is an optional step, I will say, because it really depends on whether if your kids or whether if you want to provide this for your kids or not, and that is to save up for your child's education fund. I often heard my client said, "Hey Thomas, I don't think I will save for my kids' college tuition because once my kids turn 18, they are now grown up and they can choose to attend college or not. And if they choose to attend college, they can either work to fund themselves or ask for student loans." It's true that parents should not be obligated to save for their children's education. But imagine, when you're almost going to retire, your kids are still at your basement because they cannot afford to move out because of the student loans. And I see so many people who are retired and their kids are at 40s already and they just finished paying off their student loans and slowly saving up for other financial goals. So imagine who they're going to turn to if they have financial difficulty. So yes, it's quite ironic that when you're planning to retire early, you also need to think of your dependents too. Utilize the RESP, not only the governments give you the extra 20% bonus, if the kids don't go to school, you can transfer the principal plus interest back to your RESP anyway. Now that you save up an emergency fund, build up an investment portfolio, and save up an education fund for your kids, the only thing that stands in the way between you and financial freedom is your mortgage. Can you imagine what your life would be like without a mortgage payment? Any extra money you can put towards your mortgage every year could save you tens of thousands of dollars in interest. Most banks allow you to pay a lump sum of money up to a certain percentage of your mortgage every year. So if you have any extra money lying around, you should definitely consider taking advantage of this to help you pay off your mortgage faster. This is also where the concept of passive income is important. Examples of passive income include dividend-paying stocks, the rent minus all the costs from a rental property, or businesses that require very little of your time to manage. Most wealthy people and early retirees have multiple sources of passive income. Once you pay off your mortgage, guess what? Congrats, you've finally made it to the last step, and that's to live your life like baller. I'm kidding. The last step to financial freedom is to keep building wealth and give back. When you ask most of the early retirees, reaching financial freedom doesn't mean that they will live lavishly, but it's actually quite the opposite. They will continue to live frugally. You might heard of that some lucky individuals won the lottery and got rich overnight, but chances are these individuals could not retain their wealth because they live like a baller and haven't done any proper wealth management and retirement planning. Don't worry though, this won't happen to you because you just went through this video and you have the knowledge now. Now is the time for you to take action so that you can be financially literate at the time that you desire. It's totally achievable if you have the right mindset, follow the right steps, and be persistent about it. If retiring early is one of your goals, or if you already reached that stage or know someone that's successfully done it, leave a comment down below. I would love to know what you guys think about this topic. This is Thomas, and I will see you guys in the next video.